has, or was, already a legend in his adopted home of Spain. Married to a local girl and the father of a brand new baby, Stevens dedicated his win to his greatest fans. Paul Lockyer took a visit to his proud village.
This is just part of the Neil Stevens fan club in Spain. A Canberra boy unfazed by the fame he's found abroad.
It'd be probably like Mal Meninga going for a walk down the main street of Canberra, I suppose. But it's really very pleasant. It's nowhere, it's not, it doesn't smother me at all. It's something that I've sort of wished for all my life, and now I'm living it.
I think after all these years of trying, Neil Stevens has cracked it this time.
Riding in his sixth Tour de France, Neil didn't dare to think until the very last moment that he'd finally fulfilled his long-held dream.
And Neil Stevens may have made the move of the race here, and what a wonderful result that would be for the little popular man from Canberra. He
was given. And it wasn't really until about 500 or 600 metres out that I thought that, you know, I'm going to win this stage in the biggest race in the world, and it was a real rush, you know, it sort of came all of a sudden.
This has been a brilliant move by Neil Stevens, and I think he believes he's going to do it. This is going to be one of the happiest moments of his sporting career.
And in that moment of triumph, the gesture that was to set Neil apart from every other stage winner.
I thought, no, this is a too good a moment to just give it to myself, and I wanted to dedicate it to my wife and to my baby, and so therefore the rocking motion.
So Neil, what do you think she'll think of what you did that day when she's old enough to comprehend?
Yeah, I don't know, you know, like, it's obviously going to be very complicated to explain to, you know, what her father was and what we did, and the other stage win in a Tour de France is sort of, I suppose, by the time she's old enough to understand, it'll still exist, and so, yeah, she'll probably be able to grasp the depth of it.
How important is she to your life?
A pair of these girls are probably, yeah, there's a very important part at the moment. You know, my family in Australia have been the driving force throughout the years, and more these two girls here are now the driving force behind it all.
Neil calls this his second home, a village in the rugged hills near Spain's border with France. He came here to join a professional cycling team 8 years ago, fell in love with the area and with a girl called Amaya.
She was the checkout chick in the local supermarket, and I used to go and do my shopping there, and obviously more and more I went down to do my shopping there, and one thing led to another.
The proud parents of 5 months old Myellen.
Some Aussies here,
aren't they?
Is he a good bloke? Neil could never have imagined when he was growing up in Canberra that eventually he'd make his home here in northern Spain. But then again, he would have scoffed at ideas that one day he might be an international road cycling star. He was, by his own admission, a reluctant teenage cyclist, and it was only the persistent prodding of his family that got him started.
A few Sunday mornings, I know that when I was still in bed and they came back from their training rides, they actually strapped the bike onto me when I was still in my pyjamas. But, over the years, I sort of, my love for cycling grew, and I still love going out with my mates and having a ride and then having a beer afterwards. But, obviously it's a business now as well as a good way to pass the time.
Most part, though, he passes the time alone in these hills, maintaining a tough training regime that's made him one of cycling's fiercest competitors.
They've got the coast, they've got the mountains, and obviously, if anything, there's probably too many mountains, you know, because quite often it's hard to find an easy ride.
It was Neil's father, Finn, who initiated the family interest in cycling.
Yeah, it's a special relationship I had with my father. He was more of a mate than he was a father.
Neil's brother, Brian, now a coach of our Institute of Sport road cycling team, was also encouraged to race. But when their father suddenly died, the boys had to stop cycling and run the family trucking business until they could sell it.
His death sort of was was a real tragedy to me. And over the following years, to get back on the road and to try to continue my cycling career.
Well, if at first you don't succeed, just keep on trying. That's Neil Stevens' motto in the Tour de France, and tonight it succeeded.
And as he basked in the glory of his greatest victory, Neil celebrated the memory of the man who'd done so much to motivate him early on.
If there was one thing that I regret in my, you know, of this moment in my cycling career, is that my father's not there to see it, you know. And I really would wish that he had have been here now to see it. And the only consolation I have is to think that, you know, he's up in heaven and he's looking down on me and he knows that I've done it. And I don't know, he'd pat me on the back and say, "Good on you, mate," and he'd take me off to have a beer as well.
As one of our foreign legion of road cyclists, Neil knew there was no easy way to gain recognition and break into one of the top teams, to ride alongside the best of the Europeans.
How tough has it been all these years overseas getting to that point?
Bloody tough, yeah. Now, I've had periods in my career when I've really wanted to just pack up my bags and go home. You know, there's been periods when my teams have gone broke, when I've been without money, when I've been without any idea what was around the corner.
At the Spanish seaside city of San Sebastian last weekend, Neil Stevens was reunited with his Festina teammates to ride in a one-day World Cup race through the Basque country he knows so well. The more illustrious riders in the squad were overshadowed by the local hero. As the top 24 cycling teams in the world lined up for the start, Neil gave a fellow Australian, Scott Sunderland, of the GAN squad, the lowdown on the course. They've been bumping into each other like this in Europe for more than a decade.
What went through your mind when you saw this bloke out there winning the stage of the Tour de France?
He deserved it.
Thanks, mate.
He's been riding so well for so many years now, and he's done it tough in the beginning to get his career established, and always been there for everybody else, and he's renowned throughout the cycling world as the guy who does all the work for his leaders.
At 33, Neil Stevens believes Australian representation in the Sydney 2000 Olympics is beyond him. In fact, he says he may only have another year's cycling left. Then some crucial family matters will have to be confronted.
I'd dearly love to go back to Australia, but I know that my wife, she'd dearly love to stay here, but that's a bridge we're going to have to cross when we get to it, and we'll just have to work things out and see which one comes out for the better for the three of us.
In the meantime, there'll be no easing off by this celebrated veteran in his intense commitment to the sport. He's now setting new goals for himself.
Is there another stage win on the Tour de France left in these legs?
I'd like to think so, you know. It won't be for a lack of trying, you know. I've got other races left in the European season. I've got the Tour of Spain in a few weeks' time. And then there's next year's Tour de France, next year's Tour of Spain, and many other one-day races. So, yeah, we'll get out there and have a go.
Good on you, Stevo. One of the great sporting stories for 1997, and boy, are the cyclists some of the toughest sportsmen you'll ever run into. After the break, we find out why Big Buck...